What is up, you guys? Welcome to Valentino's Closet. This is gonna be my first video. Today we're gonna be reviewing the Saint Laurent 40 Harness White Chelsea Boot. Basically I'm gonna be talking about this shoe, reviewing it outside for you guys. If you guys want anything else to talk about with this shoe, just comment down below. Any questions, I'll be sure to answer them. If you guys wanna see more stuff that you could possibly wear with this, just let me know. I'm gonna throw in a couple weekend or like outfit rotation videos and stuff, or just like, how can I say, like a spring lookbook. It's spring break now, so I definitely gotta come out with that now that I think about it, a spring lookbook. But awesome shoe, and let's go outside and get a better look at it, shall we?
It's the last days to the rodeo. Last night had me down in the bag, comatose. Don't think sunshades and a pill gon' help. Once I'm gone, can't tame myself.
If you guys notice a difference within the audio, it's because I'm using my portable microphone. Man, it sounds so weird with the voice. My voice playing back. But yeah, so if you guys like this, let me know. It looks pretty clear. It sounds pretty good on my end. Hopefully it sounds just as good with the microphone and everything. So let's go ahead and get these shoes open. If you guys don't already know, this is the Saint Laurent White 40 Harness Boots review. So basically going to be talking about these shoes today, which I've had for about a while. I've already done a slight video on them, but I'm basically going to be doing this clip, which is going to be about everything this shoe comes with, and on top of that, how it's been holding up. Past, I don't know how long have I had it. I would say for about, how long have I had this shoe for? All right, so here's pretty much the shoe. I would say the quality is, ever since I've had it, I've never been disappointed. The first thing I want to talk about is probably the contents of the box. So when you first get your shoe in, both shoes are gonna come with dust bags. These dust bags, the quality of them, man, it feels so weird doing these reviews. I haven't done these in a long time. But the quality of these dust bags, I would say, are impeccable. They're incredible. Damn, I should be a rapper. Shout out to 21 Bomb the Real Saint Laurent Don, you know what I'm talking about. But yeah, amazing quality. The inside is made of like a twill material. Feels great. They're both really big bags. It comes with two, one for each pair of shoes. I mean, usually when I see reviews on anything Saint Laurent, the dust bags are usually black. Anything else, I would assume to be fake or counterfeit, because I have not seen anything like that. One thing I want you guys to look out for when you guys order these shoes online, or any kind of Saint Laurent product, whether it's from the website or anything, any kind of website, I would say Essence or even the Saint Laurent website or Farfetch, usually it should come with its authenticity card. This basically lets you know mostly everything that's going to involve the shoe, and then in the inside it's basically like a little miniature handbook, and it's also going to come with the authenticity card, which basically tells you that your shoes are 100% legit. My shoes came with a shit ton of paper, so that, which is always good. I mean, usually luxury sneakers come with a crap ton of paper for you to take care of your shoes well, but this is pretty much it. So when you're ordering them online, you get them in, you're going to get a bunch of tissue paper, authenticity card with a little handbook, black paper, wax paper, two dust bags, and your pair of shoes. So let me go ahead and put this box right here. This box is massive, probably nothing near as big as the Fear of God box I have upstairs, so that shoe's probably going to be coming up next. But yeah, man, these shoes are freaking incredible. For these shoes, they retail for $1,145. Yes, that is steep, but if you are heavy into fashion or heavy into streetwear, I would definitely recommend these boots. These are shoes that you can wear weekly. I don't want to say every day, because this does have a 40 millimeter heel, I want to say. I think it's 40 millimeter. I can do some more research on that, but this height is 40. That's the size. Therefore, bigger than the Jodhpur. I believe the Jodhpur is like 30 millimeter, and my Represent clothing boots are also 30 millimeter. So size 30 as well. So therefore, man, like, these are gonna hurt. You can't wear them too much. That's why I don't want to say they're daily shoe. It's more like going out on the weekends or hanging out with like a girl, or if you're a girl hanging out with a guy, you're trying to flex a little bit, you know what I'm talking about, in your little Saint Laurent, you know what I'm talking about, a whole lot of gang shit. I pretty much got these because I'm more of a boot guy now, man. But enough of that. The shoe on the top is going to be made out of a super, super soft buttery suede. As you guys can see, every time I move my fingers one way, in another way, the suede just changes colors back to back. So the suede is extremely nice. I've worn these 20 times. You can see it still holds up perfectly. The inside is made out, I believe, of calfskin leather, which is also extremely soft as well. I'm going to have overlay so you guys can see the inside of that too. The Saint Laurent zipper is, I don't think it's a Riri zipper, but the quality is still amazing. Like, it's zipped up and down with no problems. It's gonna be a little bit more harder to zip because it has the paper inside. It comes with paper inside for the neck of the shoe and also for the foot. Buttery suede, from the toe all the way to the neck. Caskin leather in the interior, which is black. Should say Saint Laurent at the bottom in gold. Saint Laurent in the bottom here. Bottom is also made out of leather as well. Yes, you guys are probably thinking, oh my God, it looks ugly. Is this gonna happen? Yes, it's gonna happen. It's a leather bottom. It's the same thing with your belt. A lot of leather belts, when they're used and worn often, they're gonna start to fade and crack, which is really no problem, man. Like, to be honest, man, with the thing with these Saint Laurent boots, it's like they're kind of like Jordan 1s or any kind of older Jordan. The more you wear it, the more character it's gonna get. And I just think this shoe is just a beautiful shoe. I can't really complain with it as well at all. Brass buttons, brass buckle, just an overall quality shoe. Like, the stitching on the outside is also amazing too. Like, I cannot complain at all with the stitching. Like, Saint Laurent did an incredible job. Here's a back side of the shoe with the strap going around from the back. Like I said, these shoes are $1,145. Where I would recommend you guys to get these is definitely the store Essence. If you can't find them on Grail, I'll definitely recommend you guys to get them on Essence, because every spring season and every Christmas holiday season, they do a massive sale. Unfortunately, I was impatient and I decided to buy these a little too soon. But no, I don't know. I'm not really tripping. I use my car insurance money to go ahead and get that. Some lady hit my car at work, and her pair was like $1,500, and it was just a tiny little scratch for $1,500. So I had to spend that money for some pair of shoes. So yeah, I had to finesse that, but I went ahead and got these. When it comes to wearing these with your jeans, something I would style these in, this is definitely something you can style with your skinny jeans. That's Saint Laurent's kind of, that's their aesthetic is skinny jeans. I would not, please don't, guys, if you're wearing these, don't tuck your jeans inside the shoe. It's gonna look terrible. Just wear your pants on top of the shoe and it'll look amazing. Don't tuck them in. They're not a pair of Jordans. This is not something you can do that with. But I would recommend jeans. I would not wear raw denim, because raw denim will colorize the neck, and that's not something you want to do with a pair of $1,400 or $1,200 shoes. So just regular denim jeans I would recommend wearing. Definitely distressed denim. This definitely has that old vintage look. It's definitely that kind of looking shoe, so adding that kind of characteristic with your denim is going to be amazing. It's going to look great. Also with a pair of, not even a pair, but I would say like a fucking vintage t-shirt or some shit. It's also gonna look incredible too. Trousers, they'll look amazing. Crop trousers, dress pants, they'll look incredible. I like to wear that with these as well. What else could I like to put? I would not wear some shorts with these. Please don't wear shorts with these. But yeah, man, so jeans. Don't wear raw denim. Only wear your raw denim, I would say, with some leather Chelsea boots, cropped trousers, regular trousers, smoking pants, and regular denim jeans. Not raw denim, regular denim. That's something that I would recommend wearing this with. I'm gonna go ahead and put some overlays up while I'm talking, so you guys can see the different the different things I'm talking about. So yeah, man. So that the sneaker, the shoe, it's incredible. I love this thing. It's probably my second favorite shoe in my whole entire closet. If you guys are wondering where you can get your bottoms done and is it recommended, yo, if you're paying that much for a shoe, let it wear out over time. I mean, if you want to go ahead and put go to a cobbler and get your bottoms done, then go ahead and do that. But dude, it's a shoe, it's going to be worn anyways, and no one's going to pay attention to the bottom of your feet. So if you want to spend the extra $30-$40, knock yourself out. But if not, if is it really necessary? In my opinion, not really. The shoe is going to be, it's a shoe, man, you're going to wear it. So all that stuff isn't really, I wouldn't really worry about all that. But so like I said, leather bottom, calfskin leather interior, brass buttons with brass buckle, brass zipper. Just an incredible shoe. It's probably one of my favorite shoes I have in my entire closet. Probably one of the only shoes I paid retail for. Here's the box. I got it from Essence. If you guys want to get a good look of it, I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you guys can see what you guys are going to be looking out for when it comes to buying these same shoes on Essence or from Grail. So you guys know what you guys are looking out for. This is size 44.5. If you guys want to know how these shoes fit, I would definitely recommend going true to size with these shoes. These have a tight toe, so I definitely recommend going true to size. It's not something you can go small in. I'm a size 11.5 naturally. Just stay true to size. You can go one size up, it's not really gonna be much of a problem, but I would not settle for a size smaller than natural size. Because like I said, you don't want to walk around with your feet hurting. These heels are already killer enough. Don't make your feet, your toes suffer. You're gonna take your shoe off and your toes are gonna look like this. They're gonna be throwing up gang signs and shit. That's not what you want. So I appreciate you guys for watching and for tuning in. Anything else you guys want me to review, comment down below. Let's go back upstairs into my room. Peace.
Thank you guys so much for watching the video. Be sure to leave a like and also comment down below. Like I said, if you guys have any other questions, I appreciate you guys for tuning in and for watching. Anything else you guys want me to react, review, or just any kind of other clothing videos that you guys want to see, just comment down below. Be sure to answer them. Just anything you guys see me wear in my closet, if you guys want to get a better look or a review, let me know. Overall, amazing shoe. I recommend you guys pick this up if you guys have the money laying around. You guys can definitely find the cheaper prices around like $700-$600 on Grail, but retail, these retail for $1,145. So that's like over $1,000. So if you have the money, be sure to save, be smart, and you can find a good pair. Essence, Farfetch, Barnes New York, Saint Laurent store. Those are all good places to pick up your shoes. Saks Fifth, Nordstrom's has them too. I don't think Saks Fifth Avenue sells them, but awesome shoe, my favorite. Check them out. Thank you guys for watching, for tuning in on my main channel and my React channel down in the comment box below. If you guys want to see more of me, be sure to follow me on all my social medias in the description box below or the end card of this video. Peace out, Pati, like always. This is Valentino's Closet signing out for yet another video. I'm out. Peace. I said 5 to a 10, I said 20 to a 50, 44 they hit your water shot it, burn me Saint Laurent with the Fendi. I said 5 to a 10, I said 20 to a 50, 44 they hit your water shot it, burn me Saint Laurent with the Fendi.